guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am super excited today to talk to you about sublimating on permanent adhesive vinyl. Okay, now this has been, we'll say, in the experimental phase for a while. Everybody's been trying to figure out the right heat settings and the press settings and that sort of thing. Now, you know, these are what has worked well for us, and I am super excited to share this with you. So, all of my sublimation enthusiasts, let's get ready to find another great way to marry our vinyl cutter and our sublimation crafts.
Okay, guys, so what I have here is I have three shapes that I cut in vinyl and three corresponding sublimation prints. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I am going to use a teeny tiny bit of my adhesive spray, and I'm going to line these up. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be holding them up to the light. That way I can see through and make sure that they get lined up correctly. So you're gonna see these disappear one by one, but I'm just gonna give them literally the briefest spray. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna move these out of the way. I'm just going to focus on one. Now I have my easy press preheating at 350, and we're gonna press for 25 seconds. I'm gonna put my blowout paper sandwiched in between, and I'm just laying that down on top, and then we are going to let this cool. So it definitely sublimated well. The only hard part about this, and I did hit this one a little hard with the adhesive spray, but I need to peel the vinyl from my paper. So once I get it started, I can tack it down, peel it off. Alrighty, one down. I'm gonna go ahead and line up the other two, and we will do those at the same time. Okay, so these are completely cool. Like, for once, they really could not get any cooler. Like, they are completely room temperature, okay? And what I'm gonna do, I do need to try to grasp the edge, see where it's attached to the paper, and peel it back. And then one of the areas where it bubbled, I can actually just peel it off, press it back down. All right, so that's two down. Where'd my other one go? There we go. And this will make number three. All right, and there we go. Actually, I think this is the best one out of all of them. All right, so what I want you to see is that these have a matte finish. So this was originally glossy adhesive vinyl, and we do have a matte finish. Now this one was not very bright to begin with. This one I feel like has pretty good color saturation, and so does this one. It is not as crisp as what I would expect. So I will hold off my overall opinion until the final wrap up, but this is the process that you use for sublimating on 651.
So, what did you think about our decals? Now, I know there's probably a lot of questions like, why didn't you just use print and cut? Or, you know, what's the big deal about sublimating on permanent adhesive vinyl? Well, guys, it's just always about trying new things, learning new things. Now, I will say, okay, I do not get the same quality prints from my regular everyday printer. My sublimation printer prints better. So that is also a big advantage of being able to do this, all right? But you know, everybody has their own reasons. We're just really excited to share these ideas with you, okay? Now, of course, if you have any questions, make sure you put them below. I always love coming back in and checking in with you guys. And make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I always try to have a lot of great and fun ideas for you planned for the future. So, all right, guys, I appreciate you stopping by today, and we'll see you next time.